Good morning, children.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, children. Good morning. As I had mentioned on WhatsApp, today's class will be revision on statistics and Heron's formula. Please write down the question and work the answer. You will be seeing questions one by one on the screen. So to answer this one, you will have 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, I'll take you to the next slide. Please write down the question and then work the answer. Is it over, children?
One minute, ma'am. Going to complete.
Okay.
Finished, ma'am.
All right. I have 17 questions in all. So we will not see the answers because then I don't know if we can attempt all the 17 questions in the meeting today. So let's first finish working all the 17 questions and then if we have time, we'll see the answers. Yes, this is the next question. Please write down the question first, copy the table and then work the answer. Yes, this is a simple one. Is it over?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. 1 minute.
Okay. All right.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. This is your third question. Please write down the questions.
Ma'am, could you please show me the last question? I didn't take a screenshot.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
Completed, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, can you just show me the second one? One.
This one?
Yes, ma'am. 1 second, ma'am.
Yeah. Children, I want you to write the question, but just in case you feel you don't need the question. See, I want you to write the question so that when you revise, you have the question and the answer with you.
Yes, ma'am, I'm writing it, ma'am. I'm writing the questions.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am. I have completed it.
Children, we'll see to that we don't have to go back to the earlier slides. Please write down the question first. Don't take a screenshot. Write down the question. In addition to writing the question, you take a screenshot, but don't take only a screenshot. Please write the question. You might need about 10 minutes to work this, children. I'll just get back. Please work. class, use the emoji. Raise your hand. Shreyas, Vasudevan, Shivani, Nikita, Deepika, Hitesh, Arav, Ananya, Kanishka, Pratiksha. Hi, Tarun. Unable to use the option. Tarun? All right, children. Yeah, please come to me.
Ma'am, I'm there, ma'am. I'm unable to use the emoji, ma'am.
All right, I assume so, Tarun. Okay, yeah. Yes. Thank you.
Ma'am, can you show the previous slide?
Yeah, somebody asked something. I was not at my desk.
Ma'am, can you show the previous slide?
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am?
Yeah?
Ma'am, after this question's over, can you just show me the first question, ma'am? Because I went out and came back. So when I went out, you have changed the second slide, ma'am.
I'll do it right.
Ma'am?
No, I'll do it right now, I said. I'll show you the first slide right now.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Take a picture. You can write it later. Take a picture. Done, Shivani?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Do you need more time, children? Or can we go
to... No, ma'am.
Finish this?
Yes, ma'am.
Completed, ma'am.
All right.
Completed.
See, if the graph is, if the histogram, if the representation is incorrect, you don't have to, make the correct representation. You don't have to do that. You just have to comment. Do you think this representation is correct? If yes, yes, it is correct because of whatever reason. If you say no, then why? The answer is expected only in words. If the graphical representation is incorrect, you don't have to show the correct graphical representation. You just have to explain in words why, if you say yes, why is the graphical representation correct or why it is incorrect in words. All right. I'll just wait for another 2 minutes. All right, here's the next one.
Finished, ma'am.
Yeah. Yes, this is a simple one. Next question.
Ma'am?
Yeah?
Ma'am, now itself we have to work with answers also, no, ma'am?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Completed, children. Working?
No, ma'am. Working, ma'am.
Okay, okay, fine, fine. Please let me know once done.
Sure, ma'am.
Yeah. Looks like all of you taken a long time for this, children. Very straightforward question.
Okay. 1 minute, I'm going to complete it. Last one.
Okay. Now it's time. I'm taking you to the next slide. Is this over, children? Have you answered question number 11?
Yes, ma'am.
Others?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Just in case somebody is not sure, take a picture. Okay, this is the 12th question. Children, I'm right here. I've just put my microphone on mute. Please let me know when you're done with the answer. Children, I'm right here. I'm just putting my microphone on mute. Please.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, please let me know once you complete. Yeah.
Completed.
Okay. Just wait for a minute and show you the next question.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. This is the next one. Class, use the emoji, raise your hand. Lower your hands. Class, lower your hands. No, because some were already raised. Yeah, class, use the emoji, raise your hand. That's great. Thank you, children. That's great. Very good. Please continue. Yes, I think that was sufficient time to complete. Let's see the next one. So find the percentage increase in the area of a triangle if each side is quadrupled. Meaning the sides of the new triangle are forced four times the sides of the original triangle. Four times. Doubled, tripled, quadrupled. Doubled two times, tripled three times. So here, quadrupled four times. I think this will take some time to work, children. Just write this question. You may complete it later. I think we can see the answers only in the next class on Wednesday. because this will take quite some time to work. And also, I think we have three more questions to go. Yeah, three more. Let me just have a look at the questions. I think we can. Okay. I think we can. Yes, let's go ahead. Please work this. Yes, children, we do have time to work. Yes, please work this. Original triangle ABC. New triangle 4A, 4B, 4C. Original triangle ABC, sides ABC. New triangle, sides 4A, 4B and 4C. Almost done, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Can you share your answer, Kanishka? What's the percentage?
I'm doing that only, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, what's the new area? Okay, just in case you have not completed, you can do it later. We'll see the next one. So this again is a direct question, children. The sides of the triangle are 11 centimeters, 60 centimeters and 61 centimeters. Find the altitude of the shortest side. You have to find the altitude on the shortest side. So you should take the shortest side as the base and find the corresponding altitude. Please write down this question. I'll just show you the next one. I just wish to show all the questions. You can complete later before the next class. Please take down this question. Yeah, this is the next one. Yeah, we'll work 16 and 17 in the class. We'll do 16 and 17 in the class. Work this now. The sides of a triangle are x, x plus 1 and 2x minus 1. And its area is x root 10. Find the value of x. Yeah, over to the next question. Okay, there's a mistake there. So the sides of a triangle, not sales. The sides of a triangle are P, Q, and R. If P plus Q is equal to 45, Q plus R is equal to 40, and P plus R is equal to 35, then find the area of the triangle. The sides of a triangle, children. The sides of a triangle are P, Q, R. P plus Q, Q plus R, P plus R given. Find the area of the triangle. Write the three equations one below the other, children. P plus Q is equal to 45. Q plus R is equal to 40. P plus R is equal to 35. Write these three equations one below the other. And add. Add and tell me the result. Add the three equations, meaning add the terms in the left-hand side. Add the terms in the right-hand side. And you'll get a new equation. You'll get a new equation. Tell me that equation. Yes, what is that new equation you get when you add the three given equations? P plus Q is equal to 45. Q plus R is equal to 40. P plus R is equal to 35. Write these three equations, one below the other, and add the three equations. How do we add? Now, in the three equations, we have some terms in the LHS. Add them and write it on the left-hand side. Is equal to, add the numbers 45, 40, and 35, and write it on the right-hand side. So that is a new equation you will get. What is that new equation?
Ma'am, is it 2P plus 2R plus 2Q is equal to 120, ma'am?
120, yes. Thank you, Hitesh. Correct. 2P plus 2Q plus 2R is equal to 120. Can we take out 2 common?
2 yes, P yes, ma'am.
So what will
then
you get?
Then we will get
P plus, P plus 2 plus R.
Is equal
to R is equal to 120.
P plus Q plus R is equal to 120?
60. 16, sorry, ma'am.
120 by 2, 60, correct? P
yes,
plus ma'am. 2 plus R is equal
yes,
to
ma'am.
120 by 2, 60. Okay, now P plus Q plus R is 60, but now we have P plus Q plus R is equal to 60, but it's yes. Given P plus Q is 45, then what's the value of R? P plus Q plus R is 60, but P plus Q is 45, then what is the value of R?
Ma'am, we should subtract 45 from 60.
So it's
60 minus 45, ma'am.
60 minus 45, 15. So like that we get the value of R. R is equal to 15. See, P plus Q plus R is equal to 60. In this equation, we know P plus Q is 45. So 45 plus R is equal to 60. R is equal to 60 minus 45. R is 15. Yes, now, tell me, similarly, substitute Q plus R. We know that P plus Q plus R. Okay, now you got the value of, you can do it in many ways. Now you got the value of R, right? R is 15. Q plus R is 40, but R is 15. So what is Q?
Ma'am, 40 minus 15, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
25. Q is equal to 25. Yeah, Q is 25. Now, P plus R is given. But we know R is 15. So, P will be equal to?
30, ma'am.
Not 30. P plus R is?
40.
20, ma'am. 20.
Oh, sorry, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am. I wrote it wrongly, ma'am. I wrote P plus R is equal to 45.
Yeah, okay. P plus R is equal to 35, but R is 15.
We'll get 20, ma'am.
Yeah, so like this, you can find the sides of the triangle. Now, you got the sides of the triangle, PQR. You got the values of the three sides. Now, you can use Heron's formula and find the area of the triangle.
Yes, ma'am.
So what we have to do is, yeah. So what we have to do is add the three equations. That will give you 2P plus 2Q plus 2R is equal to 120. Take out 2 common. So 2 of P plus Q plus R is equal to 120. P plus Q plus R is equal to 120 by 2, which is 60. Now we have another equation. Now we have a new equation. P plus Q plus R is equal to 60. Now, in this equation, instead of P plus Q, use 45 because it's given P plus Q is 45. So, 45 plus R is equal to 60. R is equal to 60 minus 45, 15. Now that we got the value of R, you got R. R is 15. So, here R is 15. This is 15. This R is 15. This is 15. So, Q is equal to 40 minus 15, 25. And this is 15 again. So P is equal to 35 minus 15, 20. Like this, we get the three sides of the triangle. We found the values of P, Q, and R. And now use Heron's formula to find its area. All right, children. So that's it for today's session. Please see that you complete every answer before the next class. We'll see the answers in the next class. Otherwise, I might share it with you on WhatsApp also. In case I do that, please verify your answers. You can get your doubts clarified in the next class on Wednesday. All right, children. Thank you so much. You may leave the meeting. Thank you, children.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, children. Thank you.